Good morning, students. Today we will see the measurement of electrical quantities such as voltage, current, power and power factor in RLC circuit. This is the actual circuit diagram for RLC circuit, but in multisim no, we are not going to include this transformer. Instead we directly use 12 volt source, AC source, and then 470 ohm resistor, 60 millihenry inductor and 1 microfarad, and instead of ammeter we are going to use a probe to measure voltage as well as current. In this circuit also we need a voltage source, correct? AC voltage source. Finally we will set the values and all. Okay, so we need a resistor, and from here itself we can select a capacitor, and here itself we can select an inductor. Then whatever the circuit I already told you, we need a ground source, correct? So ground is required, and then we will connect everything as usual. So with the help of the connector, so we need this connector here. So we can adjust here also. Then whether it is connected or not we can check by dragging this one. So drag this one, so it is connected, and connect a voltage probe here to measure the voltage, and connect a current probe to measure. It's a series circuit, no? So we can do this one now. We can have this here, we can connect 12 volt and 50 hertz AC supply. I already told you here we have to use the peak voltage, correct? It's not a RMS voltage. Then that should be we have to remember that it's the peak voltage, not RMS voltage. And for resistor I have told you 470 ohm, and then 1 microfarad is already there. To type microfarad we can type here U, so that it will be considered as microfarad. And then for inductor it is 60 millihenry, so 60 small m, then that becomes 60 millihenry. Then voltmeter probe, no, we can select periodic instead of instantaneous, so that the voltage and current will be varying if you select instantaneous. If you select periodic, then we'll get all the values there. So this is the thing, everything we have completed. Now click this play button so that the thing is simulated, and we will get voltage and current because you have connected the probes. So we will click grapher. So if you get like that, you put first thing you put it in auto, okay? You still, if you are not getting, then what you have to do, no? Adjust the time period 5 millisecond, then adjust the voltage. We have given 12 volt, no? So we will take it as 15 volt, minus 15 volt as minimum, and plus 15 volt as maximum. So we'll get like that. And then the current, no, to set the current, no, we can see in schematic diagram what is the current you are having the here peak to peak, 7.5 milliamps. So shall we have it as 10 milliamps, so that we'll get it as 10 milliamps. In grapher circuit, go there, set it as minus 10 small m means milliamps. Similarly 10 milliamps, so you'll get like this. See the displacement between the voltage and current. This is your first probe. Green color one is voltage, one blue color dotted line is one is current. So current waveform, so angular displacement between these two will give you the power factor. Okay, either you can calculate with the help of the angular displacement between these voltage and current, or with the help of the formulas which use theoretically. Okay, thank you all.